Mary Nell Bachman, Wellensburg.
My name is Mary Nell Bachman. I'm a resident of Wellensburg, New York. I think most of you know it's about 5 miles south of the Essex Village and the ferry dock. My husband and I bought a house here about 4 years ago and fell in love with the area and with the people here, and decided to see if we could move from New Jersey, where we lived, to find jobs and live up here full time. The year of ferry service was the single most important factor in that decision, because it meant that I could look for work in Burlington as well as on this side of the lake, making it actually possible to come up here. I accepted a position at Gardner's Supply in Burlington, where I work now, and started working there in March of 2007, and I have since that time commuted every day by ferry to work. I'm also a volunteer at the Wellensburg Grange Hall, and I feel very happy about making a positive contribution to the community as a volunteer, and the volunteer time that I have is really made possible by being able to live here and work there. It's a part of the fabric of the community. When the ferry is running in the evenings in the summer and fall, we also have people who drive over here from Vermont to come to lectures, to dances, and to events at the Grange Hall, and it provides that kind of opportunity. My commute right now takes about an hour, although 25 minutes of that is spent actually on the ferry. I actually only drive about 17 miles to get to work. Without the Essex-Charlotte ferry, I'd be driving 70 miles each way and waiting at the Crown Point ferry, doubling my commute time, quadrupling my stress level, certainly more carbon emissions, you can imagine, wear and tear on the roads, all of those issues that go into driving rather than using public transportation, which, regardless of the fact that this is a private company, it is public transportation. You could say that I actually am here because of the ferry service, so I certainly owe a debt to LCT for that, a big debt in a sense. I pay taxes, contribute to the community, buy goods and services here, bring friends and family here to visit, and promote this area to everyone I work with, including their use of the ferry, which many people in Vermont don't even know exists. I also spend about $260 a month on ferry tickets. That's over $3,000 a year that I pay to LCT for the service. I'm a very good repeat customer of LCT. And as someone who's in the marketing business, that's what I do, I can say that if you want to be successful, you treat your top repeat customers like gold, because that is what they are. They are your best promoters as well, and I think that's something that LCT doesn't understand. Like many people here, I was stunned last winter when the ferry shut down overnight. There was no warning, and like everyone else, I just read the sign posted at the ticket booth that said, no more ferry service, and it was an indefinite end to it at that time, and that the ferry was shutting down due to ice conditions, the story that was also released to the media. This is at a time when there was no ice anywhere between Essex and Charlotte, and through the entire winter that was not a factor here, we know that. There was not even an attempt by the company to reach out to regular users of the ferry with an explanation. Simply the basic customer service is just not carried out. I'm concerned about the decisions that a company whose business is providing a public service is making with no interaction with customers or the community. LCT has a monopoly, and wielding that kind of power has to be done with the interest of the public as a significant consideration. We are that public, and we need to be at the table when those decisions are made.
Catherine Seidenberg, Essex.
I don't look like that.
We're well aware of that, Tom.
I've lived in Essex for almost 30 years now. My fiance works in Vermont, comes back to Essex. Sometimes she spends the night over there. Her family house is in Hinesburg. And she just asked if I would please read a short little statement. The year-round operation of the Essex-Charlotte ferry is very important to me because it's my lifeline to my place of employment, my family home, my land, my friends for 40 years, the artistic and cultural community of Burlington, and my deep sense of place. When the ferry shuts down completely, it causes my daily life and that of many others to be unsustainable and highly wasteful of human and natural energy resources. Many people have made major life choices based on the fact that the ferry is a reliable connection to the other side of Lake Champlain. Respectfully, Catherine Seidenberg. And I just want to say thank you all for being here, and I appreciate this. Thank you.
It looks like Stephen Longo. Hard to read this one.
Sean.
Sean. Sherry.
Stephen, L-O-N-G-E.
No.
Is there some, the last person who signed up, you probably know who you are. Okay.
We'll open it. We'll open it to anyone. Gary?
Teresa, I don't see that anybody from the Essex Fire Department has addressed this, but it was explained to me a year ago, and I don't mean to presume to speak on their behalf, but it was explained to me a year ago that the fire department here also relies on the ferry for transportation of patients to Fletcher Allen. And because they have a difficult time getting air support, airlift support, makes the use of the ferry even more critical.
Anybody else who would like to
make a
statement? Yes. Just introduce yourself.
I'm Robin Gooker, and I too don't live in Essex. I live in Keysville, New York. And I have been a rider full time for 10 years prior to 2 years ago, and my children are still full time riders to go to the Lake Champlain Waldorf School, which is just across the lake. And because of the wonderful service that the Lake Champlain Ferry Company has provided, we've been able to make that decision to commit to that education. And I was in this room probably 6 to 8 years ago having the same conversation, and there were quite a few less people here at that time. And I have watched the ridership increase and the dependency increase, and I too want to reiterate that if the demand is there, then they could increase the service, and it would take their dependable service in order for more people to feel assured that they could utilize it, and it would build their business here in Essex. The people are here, they're not sure that it will run, so they don't make the decisions that I have made to commit to this ferry. And last year, when the ferry discontinued overnight, my children were driving 2 hours to school in both directions. It was hell for our family. And it's an important service. We have all of our medical practitioners that we utilize across the lake. Our family is completely dependent on this service running.
I'm Tom Gilliland. My son and I own what's known as the Ben Weaver Farm on Mountain View Drive. Ben Weaver Farm raises cattle. It is one of the largest cattle herds here in this part of the county. And we take our cattle to Firehouse because that's where we have to go to get a USDA butcher, which we can then have the cattle butchered and returned over here where it's sold in many different businesses here in the Essex County. So it's very important to us from an economic point of view that that ferry remain open for businessmen to be able to get back and forth and get out of the business. Thank you.
I'm Bill Bardeen. I'm from Willsboro. I happen to be co-chairman of the comprehensive planning process in Willsboro as we speak. I have been totally impressed with the turnout tonight and all of the comments that every speaker has made. You can add me to the medical list. I had a heart stent put in January in Fletcher Allen. My cardiologist is in Burlington. My endocrinologist is in Burlington. It's critical that I have the ferry open to get to my doctors. That's just one thing. I was really impressed with the argument about the tax dollars paying Champlain Ferry for the service at the bridge. And I think they need to think about giving back to us, you know, what they're doing down there, at least some of it. Why can't they go out and rent an ice-breaking ferry from someone somewhere? Have they tried to do that? I haven't heard that, all right? I retired from a company called Philadelphia Electric, which is now Exelon Corporation, a utility. a monopoly. Guess what? We were regulated by the state of Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. Where is the regulation for this monopoly?
Here, here.
All right. Thank you again for coming. Look forward to getting this resolved.
I'm Sally Johnson. I'm a resident of Shelburne, Vermont. I have been a resident of Essex for over 40 years, mostly in the summer. My heart is here. My graveyard is here.
Not anytime soon.
I was a neighbor of Father Ray Pecor in Shelburne. And when the guys were out here going through the ice, one of the first times crackling up the ice, and they said, we'll be here tomorrow morning. And Father Ray Pecor said, if those kids want to be out there running that boat, I'm all for it. Go, boys. And they ran through the ice very, very late until they really couldn't anymore. And then global warming, one good thing, we got it to go all winter. It was great. And it still could go. I am very bitter about the concept of private profit at public expense.
Here,
this
here,
I don't
here.
Like.
Hi, I'm Paul McMahon, and I commute across from Waltham, Vermont, and over to Willsboro daily. And I see a lot of other commuters here, others from Vermont. And I want to make a point that I sent off a letter this evening to Burlington Paper stating that, because a lot of the press seems to be mm-hmm. stating that it's mostly this side that's complaining, and it's not, it's both sides. There's quite a number of people going both ways. I'll add my voice to that comment about the taxes, too. The ferries also, if you remember, Homeland Security bought two brand new engines for the Aiken. For them, so that's more of our dollars that are put into this mix. So I really feel there's a responsibility that from those folks to give a little something back to us. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
My name is Rebecca Palmer, and I'm a resident of Willsboro. I loved a lot of what you guys had to say. One of which was. Be treating customers as repeat business, and LCT unfortunately doesn't have to do that because they have a monopoly, and we just heard in regards to the monopoly. And one of the things that we can do, and the media can do, and thank you for being here, is to write our Attorney General. The Attorney General governs monopolies, and the Bob Glennon, who is the Assistant Attorney General in the Plattsburgh office. His phone number is 518-562-3288. His email address is robert.glennon@ag.newyork.gov. Bill Sorrell is our Vermont Attorney General, 109 State Street, Montpelier, Vermont. His phone number, 802-828-3171. This is something that when we leave the meeting tonight, we can be reaching out to our Attorney General to so they can look further into this monopoly and see what they can do to regulate it. Somebody said offering a carrot to Essex, to LCT, to put in a better docking system. A community should not have to offer a carrot to a monopoly-owned company. And then lastly, our community voices, everyone who's here today, the media, thank you so much for coming down here, media, really, and the public elected officials. You're our voices. You're our continuous voices. When we all go home and we work and we go to our lives, this is what you do. And we need you. And media, we need you. And don't forget about us after you leave here tonight. This is really, really important. Thank you.